So these are some sequences, these are some sequences of the DNA. So this is called as fragmentation. You know, restriction endonuclease's speciality is they will cut the DNA at some specific sites. They will cut the DNA at some specific sites. So that is a fragmentation by the restriction endonuclease enzymes. That is fragmentation. Okay. Next one is separation. Third one is separation. Sir, here by the using of electrical power, so when we apply the electrical power based on their charge, the parts or fragments are separated. So this is performed by the using of agarose gel. So when we are applying electrical discharge or electrical power on the fragments and a plate, the charged particles will move one side, uncharged particles will move one side. So the separation of fragments by using agarose is called as agarose gel electrophoresis. Means how we are separating? We are giving electrical power and we are separating. So that is why this is called as gel electrophoresis. Electrophoresis. So then we have separated. Next thing is denaturation. Next thing is denaturation. So till the DNA is okay fragmented, but this is double strand. This is double strand. So we have to separate the double stranded fragments. We have to separate the double stranded fragments into single strand fragments. That is called as denaturation. What is the denaturation? The separation of double stranded DNA by using alkaline agents. The process of separation of double stranded DNA into single stranded DNA by using of alkaline agents is called as denaturation. Okay, now next one is blotting. So after the denaturation process, we have to use a nylon cloth or towel or nylon paper. So nylon paper or towel is placed on the that denatured fragments. Why? Because it is used for the absorption of wet from the DNA sequences. Okay, na? So nylon towel or nylon cloth or nylon paper is placed on that denatured DNA fragments in such a way the wet conditions or water are absorbed, water is absorbed into the, so that is called as blotting. So next one is hybridization with probe. So here hybridization with probe. Sir, already I said what is a probe. So if you use DNA probes, probes are radioactive substances which can form complementary sequences to the DNA fragments. So we are using radioactive probes. Radioactive probes. So for example, here it is a DNA fragment which is with unknown sequence, which is with unknown sequence. For example, we don't know sequences, but when we use probes are like colors and these sequences are already known sequences. And these DNA probes will complementary base pair with the this unknown DNA sequences. Unknown DNA sequences. Then we have to wash off the unpaired sequences. Some of the sequences are not paired. Some of the sequences are not paired with the probe. Probe means which has radioactive nature, whose color or nature is already decided. Okay, na? So this is non-sequence. It may be ATGC for example. So here this may be TACG. So when this probe goes and binds to this sequence, when we already know it is ATGC, it is ATGC, it is binding to this sequence, then we will come to know what it pairs as a complementary base pairing. So the sequence is TACG. That is the probe character. Probe character means probe already known sequence. So then after hybridization, we have to wash it off unbinding or unbinded fragments, then washed off. So then it is shifted to photographic film plate. Photographic film plate. So then under the microscope, we have to observe this photographic film plates, how the DNA fragments are paired with the unknown sequence. So then we can analyze the DNA of an individual. DNA of an individual. So this is DNA fingerprinting technology. Sir, by using known sequences, we are identifying unknown sequences. That is DNA fingerprinting. Whether these two DNAs are matching or not. Okay, now. So, for that what we have to do? First, we have to obtain the DNA. Then we have to do fragmentation by the restriction endonuclease enzymes into fragments. Then separation, this is called as gel electrophoresis. Separation of fragments based on their charge, negatively charged or positive charge, based on the size and charge. We are separating DNA sequences by using agarose gel and electrical power. This is called as gel electrophoresis. Till the DNA fragments are double-stranded. So that hydrogen bonds are damaged by the alkaline agents. So the cleaving or splitting of hydrogen bonds between the nitrogen base pairs of double-stranded DNA and conversion into the single-strand DNA is called as denaturation. After denaturation, we are shifting onto the nylon cloths for the absorption of moistured conditions. Next, hybridizing with the probe. We are introducing radioactive DNA probes which are already known sequences, and they forms complementary base pairing with the unknown sequences. So after that complementary base pairing, we have to wash off that plate. Then what happens? Which are not bind, that fragments will be eliminated from the plate. So then these are shifted to the photographic film plate. Then they are observed under the microscope. Whether two sequences are matched or not, we can identify. Okay, so these are the steps involved in the DNA fingerprinting mechanism. Okay, let us see one example. Okay, now. So, example. Sir, here, this is victim's DNA. Sir, here, this is a DNA fragment, sir. Here, see, generally, so this individual has 24 GT sequences, latter 16 ATGG sequences and 66 ATT sequences. Sir, if you want to give, you can give separate color, sir. This is one color, this is one color. This is what? Victim's DNA, sir. Next. Sir, next, if you see, DNA which is available in the, we got in the crime scene. So, here, DNA of crime scene means you got at the murder area or crime area. If you take the sequences, okay, sir, here So let us write here 49 GT sequences. 49 GT sequences. These are 1680 GG sequences. So these are 51 ATT sequences. These are 51 ATT sequences, sir. This is the DNA sequence which is we found at the crime place. Let us see third DNA sequence, suspected individual's DNA. What is this? Suspected individuals means on which you have suspense.